Hi, today we're going to be finding the derivative of a function using the limit definition and then finding the equation of the tangent line to that function at a point. So we're going to start with getting the derivative, and to do that we're going to use the limit definition of a derivative, which is here, and we're going to get the derivative, and then with that derivative then we can follow up with getting the equation of the tangent line. Okay, so here it goes. We're going to take the limit as h goes to 0 of f of x plus h. So to find f of x plus h, we take our x plus h and we put it into our function. So we have 3, we have x plus h, plug that in, squared, minus 5, and then we have x plus h plugged in there. And then we subtract from that f of x, which is just the given function, 3x squared minus 5x. And then that whole thing goes over h. So this f of x plus h that we're finding here is all right here. Okay, so onward we do our limit as h goes to 0. Keep this with it until we actually find this limit. So I'm going to do a little FOIL on x plus h squared. That's going to be x squared plus 2xh plus h squared. Distribute minus 5x minus 5h. Distribute minus 3x squared, and this becomes plus 5x. Oops, squeezing that in there. All divided by h. Okay, so I'm going to distribute my 3, and then I'm ready. So 3x squared, 6xh, plus 3h squared. So again, that is this 3 distributing into here. All right, minus 5x, minus 5h, minus 3x squared, and then plus 5x. All that divided by h. Now, we get some stuff that's going to cancel here. We have a 3x squared with a negative 3x squared. We have a negative 5x and a positive 5x. And then all these terms that are left, we're going to gather those up, and because all those terms have an h in common, I'm going to factor an h out. So that 6xh becomes 6x, 3h squared is 3h, and minus 5h is minus 5, all divided by h. And I factored that h out knowing that I'm going to be able to cancel an h. So always with that limit definition, you always end up with an h that factors out and canceling. Okay, and so my last step is actually finding this limit. So my limit as h goes to 0 of 6x plus 3h minus 5. So if I let h go to 0, that just means basically plug in h as 0 and see what you get. So we end up getting 6x minus 5. So this 3 times 0 goes away. So what I have, the 6x minus 5, this is my derivative of my function. So this was the first part of what they asked me to find. So this derivative formula here is going to be the formula that I can use to get the slope at any point that I like. So the second part was find the tangent line. And it asked me for finding the tangent line at the point, and they gave me an x value. Let's go back up here and make sure we have the right one. It says find the equation of a tangent line at the point x equals 3. Okay, so at x equals 3, we're going to find the tangent line. So a couple of things that we're going to need. To get an equation of any line, you need a point, you need an ordered pair, and you need a slope. You need a slope of that line. So these are the two things you need to find an equation of any line. All right, well, the point, I've got half a point. They told me the x value of the point is 3. I just need to get the y value of the point. So if you want the y value of the point, you can get the y value by using the function that they gave me. So we can find the y value by finding f of 3. So if I just take 3 and I plug that into the function, I'm going to get the y value at the x value of 3. So remembering what the function was, well, way back here, 3x squared minus 5x, I'm going to have 3 and then 3 squared minus 5 times 3. Okay, so that working that out, we end up with a 9 times 3, 27 minus 15. So we get a y value here of 12. Okay, here's my ordered pair. Here's the point I need, 3, 12. Now the slope you need, the slope of this tangent line, I have a formula for the slope. That's my derivative. So the slope is going to be the derivative at 3, because that's where I want the slope at, is at the x value of 3. So I'm going to plug 3 into the derivative for this. 6 times 3 minus 5. So I'm going to end up with an 18 minus a 5 and a 13. Alright, so this is my slope. This is my m. So I have my slope, I have my point, and now you get to choose what way you want to get the tangent line. Some of you like y equals mx plus b, so you can use this formula to get your equation of your line, or you can use that point slope formula, y minus y1 equals m x minus x1. Either one of them is going to get you your tangent line. You just plug in the point and the slope in the appropriate places. I like to use this point slope formula, so I like to just plug in my y value of 12 here, plug in my slope of 13, put in my x value of 3, and then just clean it up. So that's going to give me my tangent line real quick. I'm going to have a 13x minus a 39, and then if I move my 12 over, then I'm done. If I add 12 over here on this side, then I'm going to have an equation of a tangent line, and that tangent line is going to be y equals 13x, and if you take 39 and you add 12, then you have a minus 27 here. So that's our tangent line. Now again, you can get the equation of the tangent line using y equals mx plus b also. So I'll show you that as well, but if this is good enough, you can stop the video here. But if you like y equals mx plus b, then you're going to plug again in your y, your x, and your m. So we're going to have 12 equals the m, which is 13, x, which is 3, plus b. So what you have to do for this one is you have to find the value of b. So I do a little solving. I find my value of b, which by moving the 39 over, I get b is negative 27. Now you're not done there. You still have to write the equation. So now you're going to write the equation, putting your m for m and your b for b. And so your equation will be y equals m, which is 13, x plus b, which is minus 27. So you get the same answer with either formula that you choose to use. It's all preference. All right, so I hope this has been helpful. We've got a derivative using the limit definition, and we found the equation of a tangent line at a point.